When talking about SpaceX's main competitors in the aerospace sector, Blue Origin and ULA often come to mind. In recent years, both emerging powers have emerged capable of competing in the space race with the established industry giants. They have managed to put one of SpaceX's longstanding rivals, Blue Origin, in an embarrassing position, specifically referring to Rocket Lab. What innovative strategies has the private company used with its rockets to surprise its main competitors, especially regarding its upcoming Neutron rocket? Let's discuss more in today's episode of NR Studio. Upon initial examination of Blue Origin and Rocket Lab, one might think of Rocket Lab as an emerging competitor. However, after examining the actual accomplishments of each company regarding their rocket ventures, it becomes clear that Blue Origin seems to lag behind in comparison. The company has faced ongoing difficulties related to delayed launch schedules and technical challenges related to its engines. While Blue Origin's first orbital rocket, New Glenn, successfully achieved spaceflight earlier this year, it took 13 long years to achieve this milestone, significantly deviating from the company's initial commitment to launch in 2021. In contrast, Rocket Lab, despite its limited budget and the absence of billionaire patron Jeff Bezos, has made remarkable progress. In just 7 years, the company has successfully conducted more than 60 launches of its small Electron rocket. Compared to Blue Origin's New Glenn, Rocket Lab's upcoming medium-lift rocket, Neutron, stands out as a particularly noteworthy rocket. It is scheduled for its maiden launch later this year, after a development period of about 4 to 5 years. The launch will mark Rocket Lab's foray into the highly competitive arena of leading commercial spaceflight entities, where competition has reached unprecedented levels. In anticipation of the significant milestone flight scheduled for late 2025, Rocket Lab has recently conducted extensive testing on Neutron. A significant milestone has been reached on the road to Neutron's maiden launch. Qualification for the second stage has now been successfully completed, demonstrating the design, operational capabilities, and flight readiness of the stage. The company made the announcement at X, along with stunning photos of the Neutron's second stage illuminated in sunlight. The structure withstood more than 590 metric tons of force in tensile loads, demonstrating its incredible resilience under extreme pressure conditions. The structure also underwent simulated flight operations under cryogenic conditions, testing its integrated software, avionics, and guidance systems to accurately replicate real-world mission scenarios. Furthermore, the stage successfully underwent a pressurization and proof test at 125% of its maximum operating pressure while subjected to mechanical stress, demonstrating its readiness for orbital travel. Rocket Lab has highlighted the unique design of the Neutron second stage, a feature that has generated a lot of enthusiasm among enthusiasts. Unlike conventional rockets, where the second stage is positioned above the first and supported from below, the Neutron rocket uses a unique design where the second stage is suspended from above, suspended inside the first stage's fuel tank. This cutting-edge design utilizes a lightweight carbon composite frame, reducing overall weight and increasing efficiency. During flight, after the first stage flap is opened in the vacuum of space, the second stage is ejected and the Archimedes engine is fired, effectively propelling the payload into orbit. This methodical approach increases the efficiency of stage separation. As Peter Beck put it, it's akin to a fleeting opportunity, like a space escape vehicle. Of course, given the nature of this operation, it's unlikely that the Neutron's second stage will be completely reusable. Optimistically, the company may be able to salvage some of the fairing components. However, the use of a disposable second stage allows Rocket Lab to avoid the ongoing costs and hassles associated with periodically repairing a reusable upper stage. However, it's not just the second stage that sets it apart. The Neutron upper stage is noteworthy for its own merits. Its distinguishing technical feature is its static landing legs. This is a premium engineering choice. Static legs operate without the need to deploy or retract, which offers significant advantages. Static legs are easier to design and build, effectively eliminating a significant vulnerability. If your landing gear does not extend or secure itself properly, the rocket will not be able to achieve a successful landing. However, the main advantage lies in the reusability aspect, which essentially supports the purpose of landing legs. Static legs are designed to remain extended prior to launch, and their simple construction ensures that they require minimal inspection or repair between missions. By avoiding these additional steps, One saves time and financial resources for future launches. Another important aspect of Neutron is its hungry hippo feature. This innovative design ensures that the fairing component of the first stage structure remains securely attached for the duration of the flight. Rather than descending into the ocean like conventional fairings, Neutron's hungry hippo mechanism operates by opening to deploy the second stage and payload, then retracting to return to Earth with the first stage. The first stage, fully intact and retaining its fairing, then returns to the launch pad, ready to be integrated with the new second stage for a future mission. This advanced concept has the potential to significantly increase launch frequency, eliminate the need for expensive and unpredictable seafaring recoveries, and facilitate a lighter, slimmer second stage. Hungry Hippo's ingenious design ensures that the second stage is completely encased in the first stage and fairing structure during the launch sequence. The acceleration continues unabated. Neutron will be propelled by an innovative rocket engine known as Archimedes. Conceived and constructed internally by Rocket Lab, Archimedes was originally envisioned as a reusable gas generator cycle engine utilizing liquid methane and liquid oxygen. It was anticipated to generate 1 meganewton of thrust while providing a vacuum-specific impulse of 320 seconds. Initially, merely 7 of these engines were designated for utilization in the first stage. Nonetheless, circumstances have evolved significantly since that time. As per the revised specifications, the vacuum ISP has been augmented to 367 seconds, while the sea level ISP has been updated to 329 seconds. ISP, or specific impulse, serves as a pivotal metric for assessing the efficiency of a rocket engine. Subsequently, Rocket Lab revealed a transition from a gas generator cycle to an oxidizer-rich closed cycle, following operational assessments that highlighted elevated turbine temperatures, constrained margins, and an overabundance of necessary compromises. Ultimately, the initial stage will now employ 9 engines rather than the previously utilized 7. Owing to the lightweight carbon composite architecture of Neutron, Archimedes is not burdened by the high complexity or exceptional performance typically associated with larger launch vehicles. Rocket Lab is confident that by constructing a more streamlined engine with modest performance specifications, it can remarkably expedite both development and testing schedules. In January, the company adeptly executed ignition tests of Archimedes using development hardware. We anticipate the imminent commencement of comprehensive hot fire testing to validate injector performance and assess the overall capabilities of the engine. Another significant advancement in conjunction with Archimedes pertains to the materials integrated within Neutron. It will be the world's inaugural large launch vehicle constructed entirely from carbon composite materials. Rocket Lab has established itself as a forerunner in the utilization of carbon composites through its Electron rocket, which has consistently transported small government and commercial satellites into orbit since 2018. The structure of the Neutron will be constructed from an innovatively developed carbon composite that is not only lightweight and robust, but also engineered to endure the intense forces and temperatures associated with repeated launch and reentry. This durability facilitates the repeated utilization of the initial stage. To facilitate swift manufacturing processes, Rocket Lab is utilizing an automated fiber placement system capable of generating several meters of carbon rocket shell in mere minutes. Indeed, this audacious design, coupled with a thorough developmental initiative, underscores Rocket Lab's aspiration to establish Neutron as a reliable launch vehicle, particularly following its recent selection for the U.S. Space Force's National Security Space Launch Program. Anticipated to conduct its inaugural flight in late 2025 from Wallops Island, Virginia, Neutron's lightweight design, coupled with its robust performance, may well provide it with a significant advantage in the fiercely competitive medium-lift launch sector. In addition to the Neutron cargo iteration, there is increasing intrigue surrounding prospective crewed variants and potentially even dedicated crewed spacecraft that Rocket Lab may develop in the future. While the company has indicated that it is not currently developing a crewed spacecraft, it has consistently highlighted that Neutron is being engineered with human spaceflight in mind. The anticipation surrounding Neutron's upcoming debut later this year is encouraging. If Rocket Lab can successfully achieve this milestone, it may indeed evolve into SpaceX's compact partner. I have a fair amount of confidence in that. In addition to Neutron's testing, Rocket Lab has been diligently developing a landing platform to facilitate the rocket's maiden launch. In addition to the extensive testing necessary to refine Neutron's associated technologies, the company has been diligently building the foundation for a transformative achievement, successfully executing a vertical landing during the rocket's maiden launch. This ambitious goal highlights Rocket Lab's confidence in its engineering prowess and its aspirations to revolutionize reusable rocket technology. The choice to pursue a vertical landing from Neutron's maiden launch represents a bold step forward in innovation. Unlike conventional rocket designs that emphasize expendable systems, Rocket Lab is betting on reusability to reduce costs and increase launch frequency, a strategy that has the potential to revolutionize access to space. The company's extensive experience with its smaller Electron rocket, which has successfully undergone multiple recovery experiments, provides a strong foundation for this initiative. Early experiments, such as mid-air helicopter captures and ocean landings, have honed Rocket Lab's expertise in precision recovery methods, giving them a significant advantage in overcoming the complexities associated with landing larger, more complex rockets like Neutron. To realize this vision, Rocket Lab astutely recognized early on the need for a dedicated landing platform. In February, the organization revealed its intention to convert an offshore barge into a state-of-the-art landing platform carefully designed for Neutron recovery missions. The innovative floating platform will allow Rocket Lab to easily retrieve the rocket's first stage after it descends from orbit, allowing for subsequent repair and reuse. The barge's mobility provides unmatched adaptability, facilitating landings in key ocean areas regardless of launch trajectory. Peter Beck, Rocket Lab's founder and CEO, underscored the groundbreaking potential inherent in this new infrastructure. "Our innovative landing platform will significantly increase accessibility to space by enabling a broader spectrum of mission profiles that require the full spectrum of Neutron's performance capabilities. By facilitating rocket reusability, we are not only reducing costs, we are also enabling opportunities for more frequent and bold missions that were previously beyond our capabilities." Rocket Lab's aspirations go beyond reusable rockets, however. The company is making major strides in the satellite industry with the launch of Flatellite, an innovative satellite product carefully engineered to meet the growing demand for cost-effective, scalable, and rapidly deployable spacecraft. Unlike conventional satellites characterized by their complex and cumbersome designs, Flatellite features a sleek, planar architecture that facilitates efficient stacking during launch. This cutting-edge design increases the capacity of satellite deployments in a single mission, optimizing payload efficiency and minimizing costs for clients developing large constellations. According to Beck, Flatellite is our response to the industry's desperate need for adaptable, cost-effective satellites that can be manufactured in large quantities and delivered within tight timeframes. By combining high-volume manufacturing and seamless integration into the Neutron launch system, we are enabling our clients to build constellations faster and more economically than ever before. The Flatellite platform offers incredible customization capabilities, allowing Rocket Lab to adapt each unit to the specific requirements of its clients, whether focused on communications, Earth observation, or scientific research. Its modular architecture not only increases production efficiency, but also allows the company to produce satellites in large quantities while maintaining high-quality standards. This capability strategically positions Rocket Lab to capture a share of the rapidly growing satellite constellation market, where competitors such as SpaceX, OneWeb, and Amazon's Project Kuiper have been vying for supremacy. Beck characterized Flatellite as a significant step forward in Rocket Lab's ambition to become a fully integrated space company. "It's more than just a new product launch," he explained, "that completing the final component of our comprehensive ecosystem is a bold and strategic move." That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode.